Today, we're going to Disneyland.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the next Japan vlog, and this time is a very special one. This is Disneyland Tokyo. So here we are outside the park. It was the 40th Imagination anniversary of Disneyland, so there's lots of different attractions going on with the events. Here's the grounds outside the main gate. Now, for this excursion, it cost us £60 for a day pass, which I believe was worth absolutely every single penny. So in this video, I'm just going to take you through the day, what we did, and the different attractions you can find in Disneyland Tokyo. So we got on the metro to the entrance to Tokyo Disneyland, and we got to the park about 9:30, so about half an hour after it opened. This was the castle. I have seen the other castles and the other places Disneyland's before, and this one's quite special, especially with the Imagination theme as well going on. So we beelined it to the first ride, which was the Baymax Happy Ride. This is a exclusive ride to Japan, and it's basically a little bit like the waltzes, obviously with Big Hero 6 theming and different songs. I think there's at least three or four different songs for every ride, but I'll let you just listen to music. The best song was called the Happy Ride song, and luckily we actually got to experience the ride with the Happy Ride song. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. So after a very happy ride, we beelined it to the most popular ride in the park, and that was the Beauty and Beast Castle. It was an animatronic ride with proclaimed the world's best animatronics. Now, this was the longest line we waited in the whole park, and I think we waited 90 minutes. The expected time was about an hour and 20 minutes. But I think we ended up waiting about 90 minutes. As you go through, you started it outside the castle and you go through room by room, beautifully decorated. Obviously, fans of Beauty and the Beast will recognize these rooms from the film, but it's just so well decorated. Like, even when you're in the line, you don't feel like you're in the line because there's so much take in, so many references to the movie, and the level of detail they go to is fantastic. They see Mrs. Potts and Chip. It's just really well detailed. It generally feels like you're going through the castle and you're basically being in a line. It's just a really good way to trick your brain to, like, I'm not actually waiting in a line. I'm actually experiencing being part of the set and the scenery. Anyway, after that, you're led to this room where the actual ride experience starts. So you'll see some animatronics, really well detailed animatronics, go through the story of Beauty and the Beast. And it basically takes you through plot points. So look at this Lumiere. And then obviously you've got the Beast shadow on the wall. And it looks so real. It's incredible, the level of detail of animatronics. But you know, Japan is known for its technological advances, so it really didn't surprise me. So this is the final part before you actually enter the big teacups before you go on the ride. Now, I didn't record inside the ride because I don't want to spoil it for those, but honestly, it did live up to its name. Would definitely recommend. So next we ended up to the Galaxy's Edge, which again was Star Wars themed. Now, a ride that's definitely in other Disney resorts, such as Paris and Orlando, but obviously it's definitely different to see with the character speaking Japanese. There's Tom, our mascot for the visit. You'll see him a few times throughout this video. Galaxy's Edge, obviously, again, animatronic Star Wars, 3CPO, R2-D2. And obviously, you go for the hangars and just about to board your spacecraft where you wear 3D glasses and you'll be taken on a virtual experience ride. again, really impressive stuff what they're able to do in this park. And again, the interactivity of the robotics. So next it was time for dinner, so we went to like the Pizza Planet kind of thing, ordered our meals via a kiosk that he used, and actually very, very cheap. This whole meal came to around 10 British pounds, and I got the alien mochi balls, but look at this pizza. And you know, that was about £4 I think, or something like that, but it was gorgeous, the little meal deal. But the main thing was the alien mochi balls, you know, a very special rare treat, and something I've been told to go and try while in Japan. So I was like, yep, I'm absolutely trying these. But look at the little alien faces from Toy Story. They're almost too good to eat. Anyway, there will be a special video coming for that really soon. However, it's now time for the parade. Now, the parade got very busy. As you can see, crowds of people. We were actually near towards the back, but this was the Disney 40th year Imagination Color Parade. And my God, did they pull out stops with some of the characters they put. Tweedledee and Tweedledum, the Seven Dwarves you just saw. So many characters on display. And the floats, look at that. Disney's up. The floats were so creatively and so well done. Probably one of the best Disney parades I've ever been to. And I've been to a few. Coco, like even the obscure characters that you don't really see in the parks often. Everyone gets their time to shine here. And it's just absolutely incredible. And this was the event everyone in the masses and the staff, you know, big praise to them. They really well organized the seating for the elderly and the children, so everyone got a great view. Then we had the Pixar part, so we had Incredibles, we've got, you know, Toy Story. I'm just gonna let you just listen and enjoy this. So yeah, tell me in the comments down below, what's your favorite part of the parade, or if you've been to any Disney parades before. There we go, so that was just a little sneak peek. Look, there's Big Hero 6. Just a little preview of how busy and how grand this kind of parade was. You know, here's an appearance from all the Disney princesses and princes as well, the old fairy tales from the golden age of Disney. However, there is more I'll share at the end. But now, it's time for some souvenir shopping. Now, we did this actually the first thing of the day because we didn't want to go anywhere and not be able to find what we're looking for. So I got some souvenirs for some friends, and I kept seeing these popcorn buckets, and I was like, oh, these look so cool. And it's kind of a thing in Japan, so of course I had to secure a Winnie the Pooh one. Of course I did. My God, was it worth it. The next ride we went on was the Western ride. It's from Western Americana. That seemed to be quite a cool theme that Disneyland Japan really emphasized. It's a small world after all, you know, that's in all the Disneyland parks. So there's some familiarity and then maybe some different things as well, which is really nice. But here again, there's a little bit more of the parade and the acrobatics as well, the performance, the choreography, it all had to be admired. It all had to be admired because it was so fantastic and beautiful. So fun fact, it's actually culturally unacceptable to eat while walking in public in Japan. It's just frowned upon. However, here, obviously, with the popcorn buckets, everyone does it here and added this amazing strawberry caramel popcorn, which was to die for. Moving on, we've got to our last ride of the day. By the afternoon, one of the shortest waits was our Monsters, Inc. ride. And again, a very animatronic ride, but very interactive, where you're shining torches onto the different displays and the scenes would come alive. So, just to close out this video, Tokyo, Japan was an experience I'll never forget. You could easily spend all day and all night in the park. The sights, the sounds, the tastes. Now, I've only just scratched the surface of Disneyland Tokyo, but I would absolutely go again. It's unique and unlike any other Disneyland I've ever been before. So please sit back, relax, enjoy the color parade, and I'll catch you towards the end of this video for some final thoughts. If you made it to the end of this video, please comment down below your favorite Disney character. So, final thoughts. Disneyland, Japan, Tokyo. Extremely worthwhile experience. It is certainly a treat for all your senses. The sights, the sounds, the smells, the taste of the unique food and deliciousness. And obviously, being in Japan, they idolize Western culture. So there's more Western bits than you believe. However, with the advancements of technology, they really do know how to put on a show. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. And it really wasn't that expensive as you'd think. There's so much to do. And it really is kind of one of the happiest places on earth kind of things. I would definitely go back in a heartbeat if I ever get the chance. And even try, you know, the sea part as well. And I'd love to see the nighttime parade too. So I will definitely be coming back again. Anyways, thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe and stay tuned for a few more Japan vlogs and much, much more coming very soon. Thanks, bye.